This short video will guide you through downloading and installing the OpenOffice Suite, our first open source productivity tool. Begin by pointing your browser to www.openoffice.org/download. If you're using a Windows PC, just click the big green box at the top of the screen. If you're using a different operating system, click the link at the bottom of the green box to see the download links for other operating systems and languages. You'll be directed to this page. Scroll down to find this table of links and look for the row with the US English link. Move across to find the column for your operating system and click the link. For example, to download the version for a Mac with an Intel chip, click this link. For an older Mac with a PowerPC chip, use this link. Once you've selected the link, a dialog box will prompt you to save the file. The exact location where the file will save will vary, wherever your system has been configured to store downloaded files. If you're using a PC with Firefox, follow the next steps just as I illustrate. If you're using a different setup, you will need to interpret these instructions for your machine. Once the download has completed, double-click the installer icon to launch it. If need be, click OK to allow the installer to access your hard drive. The next dialog box will begin the installation. Click Next. Now, the next dialog box asks you where you want to put the installation files. This is not the actual program, just the files needed for the installation process. The default location on the desktop is fine with me, so I just clicked Unpack to proceed. Several dialog boxes will flash past, and you just need to wait until you see the next Action dialog box, which will appear when all the files have been unpacked for installation. When you see it, click Next to launch the installation wizard. In software terms, a wizard is just a set of dialog boxes that guide the user through a particular task. Next, you'll see the customer information dialog box. It's pre-populated with the active profile name. Typically, you can just click Next here. If you have a particular reason to change any of the information, feel free to do so before you click Next. The Setup Type dialog box appears next. This allows you to choose between a typical and a custom setup. If you know that you need to customize the installation for a particular reason, you can choose that option, and then the wizard will prompt you to choose which pieces of the software package you do or don't want to install. If hard drive space is at a premium, experienced users sometimes would choose this option to leave out, for example, language packs that they would never use. Hard drives have become so large, though, that this is rarely a consideration anymore. For the purposes of this installation, choose typical and then click Next. Finally, if you do want a desktop shortcut, you can just click the Install button. If you don't, then deselect the checkbox before clicking the Install button. Again, time to wait while the installation wizard does its thing. Finally, the installation wizard is complete, and you can just click Finish. Once you launch one of the applications for the first time, by going to the Start menu, choosing Start All Programs, OpenOffice.org, you'll just pick the application you want to launch. Just to run through them, Base is the database application, Calc is the spreadsheet application, Draw is, you guessed it, a drawing application. Impress is the presentation application. Math is an equation editor that allows the use of mathematical notations. And Writer is the word processor. On first launch, you'll be offered an opportunity to register your software, which is completely voluntary. If you want to register, click Next. If not, click Cancel. If you do choose to register, the next dialog box of the wizard asks you for your name, which will then be used in the document information boxes in the application. Next, you can choose not to have the application update automatically by deselecting this checkbox. That's not a very good idea. It's not uncommon for malware threats to emerge in connection with user applications, and the automatic update is a very good defense. Finally, if you choose, "I want to register now," you'll be taken to the Oracle website to create an account and finish the registration process after you click Finish. If you don't want to do that, that's okay. Just click Cancel. Once you finish the registration wizard, either by registering or by canceling, the opening screen of the application you launched, in this case Writer, will display, and you'll be ready to begin exploring.